I would like to ask you one more question before we open up for additional questions from the audience. What about content? Okay, I mean, we're all talking all the time about, yes, and they will come to our website and we will track them, blah, 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 blah. It will be amazing. We have 5 different cameras, and at the end of the day, we need content, a lot of it. And a lot of B2B marketers know how to write amazing white papers, or at least readable ones, know how to write ebooks, but at the end of the day, we need oil, you know, fuel in the machine. How do you tackle that? It basically, it's all self-promotion, you know, I don't have to put a disclaimer, right? Okay, but yes.
I think it's, we can talk about it for a whole panel. I'll say just one insight that I've learned over the last years, that probably the best converting content you can put out there that would bring qualified leads is usually not content you wrote about yourself. So whenever we talk about PR, which is very expensive, but even if you get people to experts or opinion leaders to review your company or your product, or even better, compare it to alternative solutions, that would always bring better, more leads and better leads than when you write about yourself on your blog, which is also very important, and you distribute it. But always remember that people are much more influenced by reading objective reviews, doesn't matter where, than reading anything. That even if you wrote that you're wonderful and you know you have great content, it's good. People are always a bit skeptical, so always try to think of creative ways of getting people to write about you. And the second thing about that is, usually when you start up your company, you already have bigger competitors which are out there already. So they already have the reputation, they have the target audience, they know the journalist, etc. I always say try to ride your competitors. I mean, if you know that you have a very famous competitor, get someone to review you compared to him, because people are probably more interested in the competitor than in you. But if you can get your name of your company associated with the other company name, people will go and will read it, because sometimes they look for alternatives, and you want to position yourself as the best alternative. So always try not only to get someone review. The big problem is that if someone is reviewing you, if someone comes and reads the review, he still asks himself, okay, but why is it better than what I have today? Or why is it better than the number one solution today? So it still leaves the question open. You always want to provide the answer for the question. And the best way is not trying to compare yourself to anyone, but trying to get other people to even try both services, and just, if you believe in your product and you know that it's better, so encourage people to compare you to any other solution.
So I'll give you two tips on how to create kick-ass content for free. Okay? This is free. Okay. First of all, give all your money to Pravda, then you're left with no money, so this is how you create content for free. Two suggestions. One, if you're a SaaS company, use your own data. People, the data that you have in your system, that boring stuff that R&D are compiling day and night, is the most interesting data you will ever find. Guys, I can't stress this enough. We work for a very exciting market, the SAP enterprise market. Now, SAP come out with a support pack 4 times a year or 3 times a year, okay? If you want to know everything about that support pack and how it's going to impact your system, all you have to do, you go to the SAP site, you read pages 1 through 28,000, and you know everything there is to know about that support pack. The only one who does that is the mother-in-law of the CEO of SAP. For everyone else, Panaya issues 3 times a year an SAP support pack fact sheet. It's a 2-pager sheet, okay? It's very elegant, very pretty. Looks like an infographic. It has lots of charts. What we do is we have more than 1,000 customers. They're running their system on our SaaS. We know everything they're doing. We know when they installed it, how many things broke in their system, what they had to test, how long it took them to install it. We click a button. We run that analysis. We put it in a template, and it's out in about 4 hours. That's one of our best performing content pieces. It costs us zero. Okay, think about how you can use your data. I know SiSense uses their data for some pretty funky stuff. Every one of you running SaaS has interesting data. If you don't know that it's interesting, go to your R&D, ask them what the hell it is they're doing, and learn about how you can use that data. I'm sure you will think of ideas that they find utterly boring, but if you think about a good angle of how your customers will be interested in it, they will download that content. They will give you their details. They will do everything for it. Here's an example from an offline company, if you're not SaaS, okay, back to the jet planes. Anyone heard of the blender company called BlendTech? Some of you have heard about it, okay? The story about the VP marketing, he walked into their warehouse one day, he saw the CEO with these goggles on, and he asked him, what are you doing? He said, I'm testing the new blades on the blender. I'm putting marbles into the blender and seeing if it blends, then I know the blades are strong enough, because marbles are really strong glass. And the VP marketing was going, wow, that is so cool. Can I videotape you? And he videotaped him. He got 300 million fucking views on YouTube. 300 million views. Okay, by showing him blending marbles. And that turned into an award-winning YouTube campaign called Will It Blend? They now blend everything from iPods to iPads. I saw them do that. They had to break it in half on the blender to fit it inside the blender. They took the most boring product in the world. It's an ugly blender. It's a really ugly blender. And they got 300 million views on YouTube by showing things blending in a blender. Okay, if they can do that, you can do that with your product. That's one tip. Second tip, and I'm done. We use crowdsourcing, okay? Guys, use crowdsourcing to create content. Here are two quick examples from Panaya. We figured that our audience were SAP professionals. What does everyone care about? How much the guy in the cubicle next to me is earning? Is he earning more than me? What we did is, 4 years ago, we came out with the SAP salary survey. We sent out a survey to our database asking people to contribute their salary details. I actually asked IT directors, how much are you earning a year? What is your bonus plan? And what are your expectations for salary raise next year? After that, I asked them for some demographics of where you work physically, how many people in your company, et cetera, et cetera. I got 1,500 responses, okay? I know how much the IT director of GE makes. They gave me all that information. I promised to use it anonymously, and I did. We took 1 week to produce into a nice report, okay? We made like a 20-page report with pretty charts. That report has created like 25,000 leads since by sending out that report with a good email and a good landing page saying something like, SAP professional, are you earning enough? Download the SAP salary survey and find out. And if you search Google for SAP salary, the first three results are the Panaya salary survey. We are the de facto standard in SAP salary surveys for the last 4 years. Okay, that costs us almost nothing to make. One last example. Which is more product related, okay? Initially, our first product helped SAP, companies running SAP, to upgrade for less money, less risk, less effort. So we sent out an email using Marketo. I set this campaign up in 1 week. I was like the second member of the marketing team. I sent out an email to all the consultants I had in my database. I had a few thousand consultants. I sent out an email. I said, SAP consultant, this is your chance to get your name out. I'm putting together the ultimate SAP upgrade book. I'm going to give you credit if you give me your two best tips for an SAP upgrades. I'm going to send this ebook out to 1 million members of the SAP community. Within 1 week, I got hundreds of responses back from consultants and integrators from SAP, from HP, from IBM, from a gazillion other Indian firms you never heard of. I took a week to edit their Indian English back into English. I put together a book. It cost me $0, people, $0. I did the Word document myself. And I started publishing that as the big book of SAP upgrades. That book has created thousands and thousands of leads because I sent it out to third-party lists and to my house list for nurturing, telling people that these integrators will charge you hundreds of dollars an hour, but now you can have all their advice for free. I've compiled hundreds of the best SAP upgrade tips out there. They're all in this 27-page booklet downloaded here for free. Just give me three details I need to know on the way, and that's created thousands of leads, okay? So to summarize, two things. Look at your own data. Talk to your R&D. Your data is the most interesting asset you can ever create content from. Second, use crowdsourcing to create interesting stuff like this. Doesn't have to be about your product, but it can, and that's free content for you.
Great tips. I think looking inside your data is something significant. In SiSense, as mentioned, we've done amazing things around data, of course. But to add to this, I think one of the things that are sometimes we don't look enough is our internal resources especially outside the marketing. For me, the best ideas came, or maybe not the best, but a lot of them came from speaking to different people in different departments. I spoke with R&D and discovered amazing things. I spoke with the developer, actually, in the marketing and got one of the best campaigns ever. So you need to speak. You need to just set time to, I don't know, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, sometimes over coffee, sometimes over lunch, saying we need different content, different ideas, and you discover amazing things.
Again, that I just add the following. As soon as you have this basic content, this source content, the secret is repurpose, meaning you have the salary survey. Okay, so you download it in a gated content for as a Word document, and then you create a video about it, then you create an infographic about it, and then you create 16 blog posts about it, and so on and so on and so on. You build a machine. What it does is takes, the hard thing is to get the source content. This is the biggest challenge. As soon as you have it, use it again and again and again, but just changing the format, changing the delivery method, and so on.